The stars are out. It comforts me to know that the stars will remain untouched by the blight. That whatever happens down here, they will shine eternally. Their light undimmed. There is a story about that cluster of stars over there. Do you know it? Elyndra and her soldier? A long time ago, there lived a fair maiden called Elyndra. She had many suitors, but spurned them all, for she did not love them. One day, Elyndra was sitting by her window in her father's castle, singing and dreaming, when her lovely voice caught the attention of a young soldier, and told her a song. The soldier drew near to Elyndra's window. As their eyes met, he fell in love with her, and she with him. When Elyndra told her father about the man she had chosen, he was furious. For Elyndra was high-born, but her love nothing more than a common soldier. To keep them apart, he had Elyndra imprisoned in the highest tower of his castle, and sent her soldier to the wars. Alas, not a month had passed before news of the soldier's death reached Elyndra. Alone in her tower, Elyndra wept for her love, and beseeched the gods to deliver her from this cruel world. So earnest was her grief that the gods themselves were moved. They gathered Elyndra into their arms and lifted her high into the heavens, where she became a star. The gods also raised up the soul of Elyndra's soldier love, and there he dwells, across the horizon from her. The band of stars between them is the river of Elyndra's tears, cried for her lost love. They say that when Elyndra has cried enough, she will be able to cross the river to be reunited with her soldier. This story is one of my favorites. A tale of a love so great and so enduring that it defies death and moves the gods to action. Sometimes I ask myself, does such a love exist? Can it exist? I never expected you to say that. It is a pleasant surprise. Of course not. I have to say there is a certain severity to you. Finding a person is nice. Maybe you should let your softer side show more often. Sometimes following your heart, not your head, leads you to remarkable places.
Oh, Stan, what are you doing? Ha ha ha.